my notes like I got notes.
Tasha, I was about to say, you got your phone. I don't have nothing. I'm going in naked.
As you came.
I try to think of a couple things.
Which is funny because they say you came naked, but I usually come with socks on.
Nice. Prepared. For whatever.
No. You.
And welcome.
Welcome, everybody, to another episode of the Jose and Flo podcast. This is season 3, episode 15.
15.
And the season finale, if you may. Also the finale for the year.
Mm-hmm.
The last one.
Close it out with a bang.
The 2022. Like we started off like always, what's the last song you listened to today?
The Other Side of the Game by Erykah Badu. Mm-hmm.
Okay. Well,
that's a good one.
I'm going to set my...
Shout out.
I'm going to lie, and then I'm going to tell you the song I really listened to. Song I listened to was Nobody by My Name Dwayne. But the last song I really listened to, I listened to that song before this song. The last song I listened to was Tuscan Leather by Drake. I just wanted to shout out My Name Dwayne before I forgot.
Shout out.
We had did an episode with them, but the mics died. He don't know that yet. Because it's been, we did this like 2 months ago. Yeah, and it never came out. And I edited it knowing the mics had died during it. Because, like, I saw it afterwards when I was putting all the stuff together. And then when I edited it, I was like, oh, they died kind of early. So, yeah. It didn't work out. Shout out to him. He dropped the project anyway. The podcast episode was supposed to come out before the project. The project. He went to New York and everything.
The three of us, or it was like...
Me, him, and Jess Kenny.
Oh, okay.
Shout out, Jess Kenny.
Shout out. That was that episode of... Shout out.
Mike's died.
Appreciate y'all.
It was funny, too. It was nice to talk about relationships. Yeah. I don't remember what was asked or was said. Yeah. I remember the topic was relationships.
Wow.
Yeah, probably would have got canceled. It was probably God turning the microphones off. Oh, you niggas wild.
Hey, guys. I'm not here today.
Not today.
Cut it out.
Well, yeah, this is the 2022 finale. How would you sum up your year? Think your year was good?
It was great.
You had a very eventful year compared to most.
Yeah, I did.
did a lot.
I had a baby. I got married. Shout out.
All within the time frame of now and the last episode.
Yeah. Really been I've been at work. I've been putting in some work since the last time you saw me. So
in more ways than one. Mm-hmm. Put that thing down, flip it in reverse, dude.
Yeah. But nah, man, it's been good, man. My daughter was born in August.
Damn.
So it's been great.
Time to Christmas.
Yeah, it is. She's getting older. She's turning it over now, falling off the couch. She got to watch it. Yeah. It's a part of being a parent, apparently. Wow. So, but you got to watch it, man. She's beautiful, though. And then my wife is beautiful as well. She's awesome. She's a great mother. Great wife. For sure.
Don't look at me.
I'm not looking at
you. You want me to co-sign?
Nah, but
yes.
You should.
Very beautiful indeed.
You should co-sign.
Very beautiful indeed.
Yeah.
You watch...
Tell my wife she's fucking beautiful.
You watch the Mike Epps show on Netflix? Yeah, you watch it. I watched it with you. Yeah. Like how Duck beat. Yeah. Duck, his homeboy at work with him in the...
yeah, that's right.
Tell him how beautiful your wife is, bro.
And that man just working.
Other than all that.
Yeah, that's it.
That's a lot, though. Congratulations on that job. I'm not sure exactly which one is more appropriate.
I'll take either one. Either one is fine.
Thank you. All of that. I did a lot of shows.
Yeah, man.
I did a lot of shows.
You put in the work.
I got to do shows in New Orleans and all of that. That was all nice.
Yeah,
I didn't realize how many shows I did this year.
Did you get a count?
No. I didn't know it's not gonna count. I wish I would have counted. People be counting, and I'd be like, man, I wish I knew. Like, it'd be sounding cool.
My dog would just be showing up.
Nah, yeah, I don't be counting.
Man, I heard y'all was letting niggas talk on the mic. Can I go up there, please?
Shit. Hey, if you gotta do it like that.
Say, I'm gonna get it either way.
Shit, New Orleans, Gonzales, Baton Rouge, Lake Charles, Houston. A lot of places. Mm-hmm. Other places that I can't think of right now.
Some miles on the car.
What? So many miles. So many places I got booked and they didn't work. I got double booked and shit. I was supposed to go to Alabama.
Dang, really? What book?
Don't remember. Either Birmingham or Montgomery.
Mm. Either way.
I want to say. It was this dude wanted to invite me out there, and I took it too. I was like, yeah, I'm gonna come. And then like an hour later, somebody called me and gave me a poster on that same day. I was like, damn.
Oh, like you was gonna
I had already agreed to it and everything. Yeah. Like they were sending me the poster to post it. Poster to post it on Instagram. And I seen the date, I was like, damn, like why this date so familiar?
Yeah. Yeah. I was just rolling with it, I was saying, like, feel good.
What else happened?
Why? Better not turn down a good thing.
Got a new job. Mm-hmm. I mean, does that count? Can you say it like that when it's under those circumstances?
I mean, you know, depending on who knows the circumstances.
Oh, I guess so. They don't know. So yeah. I got a new job.
Yeah, exactly.
That's about it, really. Yeah. Just a bunch of fucking shows and going places.
Yeah.
A lot of shit happened. I find it very hard after 2020 to complain about my ear.
Right. When stuck in the house.
Yeah, did the world fucking shut down, my nigga? No. And you had a good year. Right. But 2020 was a great year. Unemployment, boy. 2020 unmatched, bro. I have yet to have a year better than 2020, low key, when I think about it now.
It was the
best. Money making wise.
It was the best and the worst year.
Yes, right. It was a roller coaster. A big one. Very, very, very high highs and very low lows.
A wooden roller coaster?
No, it'll suck. Like, ain't no, even the highs ain't fun. No. A wooden roller coaster. It's like the Superman or some shit at Six Flags. Shit you tell your homeboys about when you come back home. Like how we was telling niggas about coronavirus and shit. Same thing. It's on those lines.
Shit is wiping niggas out.
But we getting money, nigga. We sitting at home. That's why it's fucked up now. That's why niggas don't go to work now.
Oh, man. I thought they cut unemployment.
They did, but I mean, niggas still.
They
They institutionalized. Yeah, like, I can't go back out in that world.
Used to be in the house. I can't do it.
I feel them, though. I feel like if we wouldn't have worked at Tetra Tech, it would have been a little harder to go back to go back to work. Like, we was making some decent money, so. Right.
I miss Tetra Tech sometimes. I ain't gonna lie to you.
Shout out to all my people that know what Tetra Tech is. Disaster relief. Mm-hmm. Shout out to them.
Never realized how much money is in there.
What? I see why niggas be flocking to that house.
They just giving money away.
No one else. You don't got no time.
No.
No time.
7 days a week.
12 hours? 13? 14 hours?
So yeah, I was saying when it's the summertime.
Sun up to sundown. Yeah. That's literally what it was. Sun up to
sundown.
Get it in. Sun going up, you right down watching it go up, about to leave.
You already writing on your look.
Sun down, that's when you writing on it again, going back.
So you gotta use bathroom, but hopefully got a gas station closed.
Or your drive is slow. So
that shit you catch a little nap though.
Sometimes.
Yeah.
Well, that's the routine. Catch a nap as soon as I get to my spot. I know exactly what time my driver coming. I'm about to go to sleep. I'm about to smoke a blunt and go to sleep. And then I start my day and I wake up.
Yeah.
That was when I had my hair. So I had a durag on the whole day. I didn't have to worry about nothing like that. One time I washed my hair outside my truck.
Oh. Wash your hair?
Yeah, because I didn't get to wash it the night before. And like it was like itching, so I was like, I'm going to just wash it right now. And I got out of the truck and washed it in the street in somebody's yard.
Man, I did not know that.
I ain't tell nobody that. You first person ever told. Boy. I was thugging on Tetra Tech. Doing I want it.
He said, I'm washing.
He washed his ass somebody front lawn.
Yeah.
You had the shampoo with you?
Mm-mm. It was plain. This was all premeditated.
Oh,
you already.
Oh, so when you went to sleep that night, you was. Oh, you woke up the next day and was like, "I'm gonna wash my
hair." I was like, "I probably will wash. I'll probably wash my hair while I'm at work. I'm gonna get some water or something."
I had already thought about it the day before.
I had already had the idea. Yeah. It wasn't just like, "I'm gonna wash my hair while I'm standing right here."
It had been sitting there for a while. It's like, you know what? Let's just do it.
The shampoo was there and the conditioner.
You did condition it too?
Yes.
Got to do the full process.
It's all good. I'm pretty sure that don't hurt the grass.
Yeah.
Even mean, do. Who cares?
Who cares?
Who cares? I'm pretty sure they had debris and shit in their yard anyway. Oh, God. Yeah. We supposed to be talking about, we talking about Tetra Tech.
Man. We talking about that, yeah. That was.
What else happened this year? A lot of rappers died this year. Man, that's every year now. To be honest, but I don't know.
R.I.P. to all the fallen.
Take Off died.
Gone, never forgot.
PNB Rock died. Boosie Homeboy, I got his name. Mo 3, I think that's his name.
Oh, yes. That was this year.
Yeah, well, I think so. At the beginning of the year, something like that. I don't know.
Oh, wow.
I think so.
No.
That's last year?
Yeah.
You show?
Yeah.
It wasn't year before last. Yeah, I know it ain't been that
long. Last year.
That's bad, though. It's all running together. The Mexican pizza came back this year.
No, it didn't.
It did, because it came back and then it went away.
Oh, and then it came back again.
Yeah.
Mexican pizza.
Shout out to Mexican pizza, though.
No.
I mean, so if you didn't, if you ate meat, you wouldn't eat Taco Bell right now? Do you eat any? You can't eat fast food.
No, not really. I mean, I'll get some shrimp Popeyes if we go. Like, we pull up to a Popeyes and, you know, niggas eat.
I'll get some shrimp.
With some fries. Double fries, if you will.
Double fries.
What? I'm a double fries.
Straight potatoes.
Straight. Every once in a while, I get the red beans. I don't know why. I just get fries. I'm a kid sometimes when I go places.
I mean, but you also under the circumstances was you can't eat half the shit on the menu. You 75%.
Yeah. The other day we went somewhere, I got double cheese fries. It was just fries with cheese on them.
Yeah, that's cheese. That's what it's in the name.
That's not what I wanted. It was some cheese fries and they had other shit on it. And I was just
like, oh, you wanted like the green olive, green olives, green onions and stuff, shit like that.
It was something like that. It was still good though. I
feel you. But somebody was telling me they went to Popeyes recently. They said they got some popcorn shrimp. They said they gave him like 3 shrimp.
Yeah, I wouldn't get the popcorn shrimp.
He was like, I opened the box. I could count the shrimp on one hand how many I had. He's like, I drove back so fast.
Especially that popcorn shrimp, you bad.
He was like, then I didn't get no fries, so I could see the bottom of the box as soon as I opened it. Maybe doing niggas dirty out here in Baton Rouge. Y'all some dirty motherfuckers at these fast food restaurants. I've been hearing. Bro, one of them told me she went to McDonald's and got a Happy Meal. Why they only put 3 fries in the Happy Meal with no bag or nothing? They just threw the fries in the box.
Wait, what?
And gave it to them. I was so jealous. She was like, I didn't pull off or nothing. I just gave it right back to them. It was like, y'all need to put some more fries in there. She said they ended up giving her 2 medium fries, though.
Yeah, thank you.
I was like, nah, I need a medium fry for every fry in this box. Go get one more.
3 fries. I can count how many fries. That's how you know it's not that many fries in there. I can count how many.
You try to eat them on the way home. That first handful, that's it. It's over.
Somebody like me. Say, I take 3 fries at once. I go in there again, say, man, say, what's going on?
Paying empty, full of sadness and disappointment.
And I'm just keep driving.
I'll take your help.
I don't feel like going back. Well, nah, in that situation, I'll go back. If it's something small, I won't go back.
The Happy Meal, you're not going back?
Nah, I'll go back to that. Yeah, for sure. If it's something else, like just forgot sauce, I'm like,
that's funny because they be showing love when I go to fast food restaurants. I mean,
yeah,
they show love though. They be giving me drinks and shit.
On the frisky?
Yeah, like I didn't, it's been a couple times I didn't went to like some, I didn't went to like Taco Bell, Popeyes, McDonald's, something, and they'll be like, "You ordered a drink?" I'll be like, "Nah." They'll be like, "You want one?" Sure.
Yeah.
Well, I've had a couple times where they just be like, "Hey, you want a drink?" Hell yeah, I want a drink. I've also fumbled the bag a bunch of times.
You know you did.
And I'd be like, "You had a drink?" And I'd be like, "Nah, I didn't have a drink." Yeah. Like, all right.
Nah, goodbye.
Yeah, and I'm like, 30 seconds go by, and I'd be like, "Fuck."
Yeah.
Then I'd be thirsty.
I'm parched.
I'm dried in his other friend.
Yeah, I've had all from you that drink when I'm thirsty.
Bro, we had somebody offered us weed one time.
At the gas station?
I mean, at Wendy's. At Wendy's. I never forget that. We was, me and Doug, we was in the drive thru.
So it's free?
No, hell no. That's fentanyl right there.
He's trying to kidnap
you. Free weed from a stranger? Hell nah.
He's trying to kidnap you.
I ain't even famous, brother. Hell nah.
He's trying to put you into human trafficking.
Yeah, that boy trying to play with your booty hole.
Oh, man. Oh, work, you trying to let other people play with your booty hole.
And you don't get paid.
Yeah. I wouldn't even know. Nah.
Yeah, we was in the drive-thru. We had ordered. We was at the first one, though. He was about to pay. We paid. No, we was about to pay. The nigga, I guess we smelled it or we looked high or something. Like, he looked at us. He was like, "Y'all fucking with that gas?" And he was like, "Yeah." And he was like, "Shit, I got it." Well, he was like, "I got it." That nigga, he said it was like a crazy price. It was like, I want to say like $60. No, it's $80 an ounce. $80 to $90 an ounce. And we was like, "What's your number?" Like, man. And he gave us on, he gave us his number.
Yeah.
Paid, kept it. We went to the second window. We went to the second window. And the girl was like, "Hey, back up." We was like, "What?" She was like, "Back up." He said, "Come back." So we backed up. And the nigga was like, "Shit, smell this." Like, he had the weed on him. I don't know if he went got it or whatever, but he had it on him. He's like, "Shit, smell this." He smelled it. He was like, okay, bet. Now that I think about it, we should have fucking grabbed it and drove the fuck home.
Fuck the food.
Yeah. That's what we should have did. We smelled it. We gave it back to him. He's like, "Bet, all right." And we got our food and we dipped. Never got no weed from this nigga. Never. In my life. To this day. He was on such bullshit. Yeah, I hit him up like 3 times. The nigga, you know, and like you hit a weed man up, he'll go ghost on you after like one or two text messages.
Mm-hmm.
He did that shit. But then he texted me the next day like, "Oh, my bad, bro. I got tied up. My brother got shot." I was like, "Nigga, what? Why'd you even text me, bro? Go ahead. Yeah. Handle your brother.
Attend to your business.
Matter of fact, fuck your brother. Because I wanted some weed." But, yeah, that was very weird.
Yeah. It's something like this. My bad. Say, "No, you don't have to apologize to me. It's too late.
Got shot.
It's okay.
It's over with.
That's yesterday. Doesn't matter now."
I don't know if that was this year. It might have been. I'm going to say it was.
Like that?
Mm-hmm. Because that was a while ago.
It might have been.
It had to be.
It was like one of the shortest, long years of my life.
Really? See, I was trying to debate it. I was like, it don't really feel like.
Like, a lot got done, but it was it felt like.
Yeah, it just that's it was, how it was. It was short. Like, when you look back at how much stuff happened, it don't feel like it went by as fast as it
did.
Yeah. Because I was debating it. I was like, it still didn't go by fast. And I was like, it kind of did, though.
Right? Just blinking and it's like, "Oh, shit, it's December."
Yeah, it went by fast, and then you'd be like, "Oh, that shit was this year?" Mm-hmm. Thought that was 2 years ago or something, man. Like that.
Man, you know, that feels so long ago. So long ago.
That's how it be. But that shit, that's straight. This is a good year. Next year, hopefully, is a little better. Yeah, every year has some points, huh?
So you got to just try and keep getting better and better.
Every year has those points where you be like, "I don't know how the fuck I'm going to get to next week."
Hey, Lord.
And then it's crazy that you get through that shit, and then you look back, and you had like 30 of those times. And they all wasn't even that bad.
But you made it through each and every time.
Yep. So many times, rent didn't look like it was going to get paid.
"But I'm a survivor." What?
Or life looked like a nigga was going to be living with candles.
I'm a survivor.
Mm-mm.
That you want to live with can't.
I guess I'm preaching, but nah, I don't like that. I don't want my congregation yelling that.
Sorry.
Destiny's Child.
Sorry.
I like the energy, though.
Couldn't think of nothing else to yell. That's why I yelled twice. The second time was supposed to be something different.
Do your thing, pimp. I ain't going to stop you, but
you are.
I'm going to give you my 2 cents.
You will survive.
Mm-hmm.
No.
Yeah, I will. My bad. Kind of stopped listening. I was gonna say, could talk about what you're looking for. I ain't really looking forward to nothing. It's just a lot. I don't know what the hell's about to happen in 2023. I didn't know what was gonna happen this year, but I knew what I was hoping for. So hopefully, the stuff I hope for that'll happen, which is just more like, I guess, out of state booking stuff like that. We want to branch out. So hopefully that happens.
More miles on the whip.
Hey.
The hoopty.
I mean, no, that's going to happen regardless. We don't need more miles. Just more show, more bookings.
More meaning.
We might get there in different means. Oh. We don't know. So we just going to hope for that.
Yeah.
Branching out more.
Like, you know.
Trying to get rid of these jobs.
All expenses paid.
Oh, shit. The store?
The store.
The store is out.
Some merch.
We didn't have a store.
Go cop some merch.
There was no store last episode. We got shirts like this one.
Yes.
Rest in peace to my parlays.
Mm-hmm.
So many tickets. So much money.
No
gone.
Tickets, no problems. I have no tickets, no problems.
I need to make like a special one. I was one bet away edition. Like the RIP my parlays. Because you always be one. You always one bet away. You have a 30 some. What is it? I ain't done that shit in a minute. 30, it'll be like a, what is it called?
30
leg.
Leg.
It'll be like a 20 leg parlay, and you always hit on 19 of them, and then it's that one that fuck you over.
Mm-hmm. I have seen plenty of those.
You need freaking Darius Smitherson, some nigga you ain't never heard of, to make one free throw. Make 2 free throws. That's how it be.
How did you get on your parlay then?
Because it'd be like an over under or something. And like you'd be like, oh, I got it. I just need this no name nigga to hit two free throws, and it's over with. This nigga ain't hit 2 free throws in his life. He about to shoot these so hard, so he can go tell his kids he scored in the NBA. And that nigga make one, and miss the second one, and then game over.
Yeah. Never go back to the line.
Game over.
Damn.
Gone. $200 or whatever. Or like
RIP
my parlays. Or like the Super Bowl. Yeah. That's just a real one. Super Bowl. It was what, 12 legs? 12 leg parlay. Mm-hmm. All I needed to win the money was for Joe Burrow to rush for 8 more yards.
Mm-hmm.
8 yards, bro. I just need 8. I don't even need the first down. Just run for 8 and slide.
It's eight
yards, bro. What happens? This nigga Aaron Donald goes berserk.
Yeah.
Next thing I know, Joe Burrow on the ground screaming, holding his knee. He ain't about to run no more.
No, sir.
And it don't matter because Aaron Donald giving him 2 seconds to throw the ball now, and the game is over. It was, bro.
It's Aaron Donald.
I had so much that was hitting like perfectly. Like I had Matthew Stafford. Whatever he threw for, I had him on the under, and the under was literally like 5 more yards than what he threw for. Like say I had him going under 216, he threw for 211. Mm. Like it was hitting, bro. I was like, oh yeah, this the one right here, baby. Yeah. This the one.
I'm hitting stuff I know you thought
about. Stuff I just threw on there just to make the money higher.
You gotta win the money this time, baby. Come on, be nice to me. Yes, sir.
Man.
And I fucked it.
So next thing I know, Joe Burrow screaming. So it's over with. Shit, he ain't getting them 8 yards. He actually lost yards. So.
He was probably closer to 8 before this play.
That was the one. That's when I took my sabbatical from sports betting.
Haven't been back since?
I have, but not like I was. I'm not betting as frequently as I used to.
Just once in a while.
Yeah, like once a month, maybe. Or once every 2-3 weeks. And that's usually just because I get some free money, some free bet.
I try to flip
it over and over again until eventually I lose it, you know. But it's all good. Fuck sports betting. Sports betting adds fun to this. It adds stress. It don't add fun to sports. I'm noticing that now. It just makes the shit so much more stressful. Because now you really got money on the line.
You invested.
Not invested. This ain't no investment. This is gambling. This shit could be gold.
Well, no, you're not. You didn't invest it, but you're like.
Oh, you're more invested.
Yeah,
gotcha.
You're emotionally invested.
But that's the crazy part. A nigga, like, I know at least me, I already be emotionally invested.
True.
But now you be emotionally invested on, like, the Kings versus the fucking Cavaliers or some shit. Like, some shit.
Because you need Tyrese Halliburton to jump.
Yeah. People you don't care about, you don't even like, you worry about, you stressing, you need them to go crazy and shit. Like, what? Why are you stressing? Because
I never care when you're on TV.
Why are you mad Julius Randle missed the three, bro? You don't even like Julius Randle.
He was hot and he's hitting.
I need him to make at least four.
And he stuck it too.
They about to take him. Put him back in the game. When you stressing for a nigga to get back in the game like you they daddy, you is too yeah. You too deep. You ain't too deep. You need to stop.
Stop all that bit. Stop it. Get some help.
Man, that was part of this year, sports betting. Because yeah. Sports betting became legal during this year, right?
I think so.
So, yeah, when I went through that whole... Yeah, right at the end of the year. And then it hit on the apps on the phone during this year.
Yep,
yeah. I remember. During like January, right before the playoffs, or right during the playoffs, something like that. It's all coming back. Yeah. I'm starting to itch. FanDuel.
Yeah.
Right now.
You be calling me, man.
Poor Leeds would be calling me, man. I just be knowing, man. Cooper Kupp.
Yeah. Two teddies. Two teddies.
Man, no. It's low-key just like actual gambling. Like, as soon as you get that hit, and you win.
Nigga, this gambling. What you talking about?
But, like, sports betting on your phone.
It hits like... Oh, like going to the casino.
Yeah, that's what I'm saying. That's what I'm trying to say.
Because they're both gambling.
But like,
that's why it hits.
But it's crazy how hard it hit, and you can't even tell. Like, yeah. You feel it. Because yeah. I remember once I was like, man, I sound just like the niggas at the casino.
It's like, brother, look, if I bet on this, I flip my money because I know.
I say, man, I just hit for 200 yesterday.
Yeah.
Say, yeah, but how much did you bet
to get that 200?
Yeah. It's like, man, don't worry. I hit for 200.
Look, if I bring the 200 back. I can hit for 800. I know it. I'm gonna turn this 200 to 8. That 8 to 1600, and then boom, we're good. We in business.
2 days later, hey man, what happened, man?
I would casino $3,200
gone. All my shit gone, but bro. That shit.
They about to repossess my house. They already took my car. They said it wasn't worth nothing. And now they won't want to get back to
me. Bro, imagine getting hit that hard at the casino. You got to lose your house.
Say, buddy, what are you doing? Get up.
You got to be by yourself.
Yeah.
There's no way somebody will watch you.
That's somebody just got, they got a problem for real. You can gamble your house away without blinking.
That credit. Sign off my house. You know how much confidence that... Well, I guess you don't. You kind of can't have confidence because you literally just lost everything.
But you do that, you don't bet all that. Like, it's like, oh, I'm going to win. It's no doubt.
But how do you lose everything to the point where you bet in your house and you can really think in your head, like, I'm about to hit... Well, I guess because you're like, I done lost so many times in a row. I got to hit right now.
What are the odds?
I'm a good Christian man.
God-fearing man.
Jesus wouldn't let me lose my house.
Look,
we'll praise him.
He's not always there when you need him, but he's always right on time. I know my God.
Ain't no better time than right now.
I know my God.
In the present. That should have turned a nigga atheist queen. You see the fucking sevens?
Yeah.
Seven, huh? What you say?
Wait. No, that's not my point.
I couldn't hear you over my prayer.
Good Lord. I didn't throw them dice. God was not got those hands when I threw those dice.
This is not a place of the Lord.
Yeah. Nah, I'm out of here.
Jesus is not in here.
He will all heal. And I shall bid you all do.
That shit funny. That crazy thing, if I ever play like poker and shit around my people, like my mama people, and you say some shit like you mention Jesus or something, they'll stop you so fast.
Really?
They'd be like, don't mention the Lord while you gambling, boy. Yeah. Don't you do that.
Say, that's wrong. Mixing Jesus and gambling.
You don't want no part of this.
It's not legal. Yeah.
don't say nothing about Jesus while you're shooting dice.
Coming, he don't know we in here. Man.
God, I need a new pair of shoes. Pick them dice up. Watch.
You about to crap, boy. You about to crap, boy.
Roll again. You can't say nothing about
that. Oh, nigga, mention God.
Dice game over, man. You don't matter.
Let's go play over there.
Yeah. Sure.
You can't come.
I'm trying to be all holy.
Hey, man, don't be kicking that shit in, man. All that Christian shit. We don't do that around here, cuz. That's funny. I wonder if that's like a rule.
Don't be kicking out of there.
Say, cuz, what you want? Whoa, cuz, what you doing?
Y'all like Christian shit.
Say, like, man, who this nigga is, man? Who you came
who
with?
Who the man is this? Say.
Nah, man, nigga talking about Jesus, man.
What you say about Christ, man?
Come over here.
Yeah, Christ.
I ain't hear you.
The bread. What are you talking about, man?
Get out. Step. Bounce.
Hey, let's be clear.
I won't skate with you or hang with you, nothing. Shoot dice with you.
None of that.
You think ATL niggas, Atlanta niggas fuck with ATL as hard as like niggas?
I don't know.
You think
no, quoting, I don't think so.
You think they be quoting ATL? Probably not. They might. I don't know. I feel like ATL is like a Southern classic. I don't know. It's not a great movie, but like it's one of them.
Yeah, it's. I had to watch it. Okay.
Bro, somebody mentioned Baller Blocking at work. I was like, ooh.
Every time they mention that, I'm like,
that's
be like,
a
what
classic right there.
What you know about that, boy? That Baller Blocking.
Ooh, you from the trenches.
Shout out.
Shout watching out to
Baller Blocking Babies, man.
Baller Blocking Babies? Grew up on Baller Blocking? I'm scared of them babies. I'm not going to.
Yeah.
You grew up on motherfucking Juvenile and Birdman and BG.
Shooting me.
Yeah, selling coke. Mm.
Mm-mm. Getting to the money, running from the
curly heads.
Motherfucker. Hey, I be saying that randomly sometimes. Well, I used to. I don't do it no more, but I used to say that shit randomly all the time. Hey, motherfucker, that nigga curly heads. Hopefully somebody say something I don't like at work. I don't know, motherfucker, that nigga curly heads.
Excuse me?
I mean, you heard me, so.
Man, bro, they cuss. They say fuck and nigga so much in that movie.
Yeah, that's the whole movie. It's just.
I remember, what's his name? Oh, TK. I did a show with TK Kirkland this year. Two sold out shows.
Shout out.
Shout out to him. Shout out TK Kirkland. Bro, he got that. When he talking to them niggas on the car, and they on the car, he saying. He say motherfucking, like, I had counted it, like, 40 times. And it's, like, 3 minutes. Like, every other word is motherfucking. I'm the motherfucking lieutenant. Watch your motherfucking mouth. Like, I was like, bro, this nigga. You couldn't even make that a drinking game. Everybody would die.
Yeah.
Nobody would make it to the next scene.
So you going too hard.
You be that bitch like this.
Toss it.
Just give me the bottle.
So we don't have enough shot glasses. Or enough alcohol for
everybody. We don't have enough alcohol. Everybody got one shot glass.
Just
pulling that bitch.
No way.
Bro, that shit. Shout out to him. He got shot in that movie. He died. But it's all. He was the good cop.
Yeah.
He was a good cop, but he wasn't at the same time.
He was a good cop that didn't take no mess.
Yeah.
Off no young
but
punks.
But he robbed them niggas.
He did rob them? He ain't no good cop then.
That's why I was like, he was a good cop because he was looking out for Juvenile and his girlfriend.
Oh, but he a good cop because he helped me.
Well, no, because he only looked out for them because his daddy got killed in front of him.
Juvenile?
He didn't look out for none of the mother. Yeah. He was shooting dice. I hope you're breaking these motherfuckers. Oh, yeah, that nigga, and then he shot him right there, and Juvenile was right there.
Yeah, okay.
Because he walked by Juvenile after he shot him, and he bumped him, and then Lil Wayne's song started playing.
Dang, that's cold bleed right there. Man.
Shout out to Gautu, though. That nigga looked exactly the same from the time Juvenile was a kid to when Juvenile was a grown ass. He looked exactly the same. This nigga didn't age a day.
Nope.
So, I mean, I guess the streets don't age as much in the streets.
Grim Reaper.
He got killed too.
Taking souls.
He got killed too. Everybody died in the damn movie almost.
Yeah.
Even the mailman.
Hey, I was just running from the fans there.
time you woke up?
Sorry, excuse me. What time did I wake up?
Almost at 3:30.
3:30? I did not wake up at 3:30. No, yeah, I did. I'm tripping. I think I woke up like 3:45.
3:45? Oh, shit, you right after me?
Yeah, I had to get, I know I was supposed to get to work at 4 o'clock. I got to work at like 4:15.
Took a nap? Today? No?
Shit, no.
My bad. I'm just asking. People do that. I do that.
They do. I didn't get to take one today.
I didn't either. Got off too late.
That'd been nice. Oh, don't worry though. My head hit this pillow tonight. I do have to wake up early in the morning.
But these hours you about to get, I'm going to make it last.
I'm about to. Ooh. And then my wife back. I'm going to cuddle. So tight.
Ooh. Just like a father.
Just snow all in her head. That's what I want.
Mm-mm. That sounds sexy to y'all ladies. It probably do to some of them.
She like it. She like it. Don't worry about it. Don't worry about it, bitch. I know somebody like it.
She didn't even know nobody. She lying her ass off. She had no niggas. You have no hoes, Miss Pearly.
That's what it is.
Who like it? Because you was at Christmas in your apartment by yourself.
We was watching that, bro. I was like, why did she have it lined up like that? That's the first thing. I was like, why did she? Like, what was the...
Probably grow too fast. There ain't no point of shaving it. I have to shave it every day.
So just line it up.
Touch it up, fucking freak brother.
just keep it groomed at least. I think that'll be better.
Imagine you was in the barbershop and you saw like you saw some like your auntie or something coming out. Get her shit trimmed.
Apparently, well, maybe she might have had peacocks though.
My wife? What?
Peacocks.
Peacocks?
PCOS.
Nah, she not in here.
Can you explain PCOS right quick?
It's when women have cysts on their ovaries. So basically, like, they have problems with, like, they may have, like, excessive hair growth underneath their chin. They may be, like pear-shaped. And it's just because it's like a hormone imbalance.
Huh.
They might not have periods. They have problems, like, with getting pregnant.
And this is cysts.
It's on your ovaries.
Peacocks.
Actually, if you get an ultrasound done, you can see them.
Huh. Okay. I learned something. Peacocks. Okay, well, she has in the case she has peacocks.
She did say she had it under the chin. That she didn't say.
Yeah, she didn't say the lip. Ah, nah, bitch, I know what peacocks is. That shit on your chin, bitch. You had a mustache. Fuck out of here. Well, in the rare case she has peacocks, then you just gotta save her from getting roasted after she leaves, because they gonna talk about it.
Yep. Gotta help out.
Say, hey, bro, did you just line her? Nigga. Every week.
Same time.
Hairy ass bitch.
Hey. That's my AT right there.
Say, nigga, shut up. That's your AT. Where your mustache?
Did she's taking your
nigga AT got a better mustache than him? Oh,
nigga, bald face ass.
Yeah, shut your baby face ass. Hey, don't you need a ride?
Get there with your AT. They was done with your haircut 2 hours ago, little boy.
Now, your AT, she take forever. All that goddamn hair.
You gotta groom up. Nice.
Oh, shit. All right, peacocks. Shout out to everybody with peacocks.
You got it.
Shout out. Remember Miss Pearly backstory? She got peacocks.
Don't even know. We get teased in the hood all these years.
That sounds like some shit, though. Like some 2022 type shit. 2023, I guess. Like, you'd be on Twitter roasting her and be like, actually, she had peacocks. And that's why she had her shit lined up. And now you canceled.
Because you're talking about a fictional character.
Motherfucking peacocks march in front of your goddamn front yard.
He's insensitive.
We are the BWP, bitches with peacocks. And we are filing a grievance against you, sir.
Yeah, BWC. you can't do that.
CWP. Chicks with Picos. Not better.
Yeah. BWC could do that.
BWM.
Big.
Bitches with mustaches.
Yeah.
BGB. No, BLB, my bad. No, BLG.
BLG.
BLG. No, BLC, even better. BLC. Okay. Bearded Lady Click.
Bearded Lady Click. Oh,
say, nigga. You talking shit about BLCs, nigga.
Nick Black.
What's black, you nigga?
Talking all that. Talking all that.
All that yip yap, nigga.
Yeah.
Chirping, chirping.
Talking.
I'm hairy, but I get down, though.
Yeah.
Twist your fingers if you're real. What set you claim, nigga? Where you from, cuz?
I don't know if you got hair on that hat, but I'm about to peel it back.
Yeah.
That was too long. It's not gangster.
You was getting there. I saw you was getting there. You trying to get up the fight? Yeah.
But yeah. BLC, Beard Lady Click. Mm-hmm. Coming to get you. Don't you talk about bitches with, what's it called again?
Picos.
Got that fast. Picos.
Yeah, Picos.
I thought you were saying Picoat at first when you was like, maybe she has Picoat. I was like, she got a Picoat. What they got to do with having a mustache?
So just because she got a Picoat in her car, she can't shave a mustache.
Look at that bitch mustache. Look at that Picoat, though. I ain't even noticed the mustache.
Man, she is. That mustache is god awful, but I love her Picoat.
It's so fire. She dripping.
Even when she doesn't wear it.
Okay, would you. Would you date a girl with a mustache? Like, would you give her a chance? Like, if you
a chance to shave the mustache? Of course. Of course.
It ain't nothing.
I ain't gonna lie to you.
Like, if you'd have met me and she had a mustache.
I don't want to sound shallow, but a mustache probably is the deal. I don't know. Like, that's just. Like, I look at you and I want to give you a kiss.
The fuck? Laughing and shit. Bitch, why are you taking this like this?
I don't know. That's just who?
What if it's trimmed up?
Hair
what
is lined up? A hair vagina I can deal with. That's different. Hairy upper lip.
Do better, bitch.
Yeah. Man.
Holler at me.
You could just. Like, we're going out to dinner. I see you fucking mustache.
My parents out here. You gonna go out like that? When you said, get nice.
I thought
you meant shave, bitch. At least. Can I speak to you?
I thought we agreed that we'd be putting the mustache away tonight. You could at least put on the makeup a little thicker.
I don't mind, but
yeah.
My daddy, you know my daddy. He don't like people having mustaches thicker than his.
He can't grow one.
Insensitive. That's why I don't got one.
So he to see a woman with a mustache. Oh,
how's that gonna make him feel?
Infuriated.
My mom's gonna have to listen to that. No.
Yeah. Exactly.
You made me feel better about saying
you laugh. Oh, that's why you laughed.
Squaw.
I thought you. My God. I can't do it.
No, it wouldn't.
That's tough.
I would be staring at it.
Yeah.
The whole time. I'm sorry, what'd you say? What's your name?
You got some dirt. Hey, I did that before. I pulled this.
Come here, baby.
He said, oh, I know it's a mustache, man. I want to see if he knows your mustache.
No. That's my mustache. It's my mustache.
Say, man, you got some dirt. You know that's my goddamn mustache.
I got a mustache.
Say, shave that motherfucker.
Ooh, that's the first thing a nigga gonna go to in an argument.
Carry up a
mustache. Fuck you, bitch. Thick ass mustache. I'm gonna go get me a bitch with a naked lip.
Your mustache. Thinking of my dad.
Don't nobody like kissing that hairy ass lip anyway. Good luck finding another nigga that'll kiss you with that thick ass mustache.
What I will say is I don't really see many young women doing that. That's an older lady thing.
Oh, Jesus. Is it?
I Well, like,
how old are we talking?
Oh, women our age anyway. But if a girl has a mustache, she's probably in high school. She's not shaving yet.
Oh, she don't know about that.
Yeah, that's what you're saying. Or she just
high school?
Or middle
like
school,
a freshman? Like, you talking?
Yeah, okay.
So you're a senior in high school? And you got a mustache? You better not tell me you don't know what the fuck shaving is. Get your ass away from me.
Shave that shit off.
You about to learn today, bitch.
Oh, goodness. Okay, so maybe.
Freshman, maybe.
Middle school, maybe.
Yeah, middle school, yeah. That's okay.
Okay, that's different then. So, no.
It also depends on what middle school you go to. Because if you... Depending on which one you go to, you're not going to be able to make it far. Without realizing it. Because the guidance counselor or somebody going to pull you to the side.
Sir.
I've been hearing what they say about you. Do you know what shaving is? Do you know? Have you tried it?
So you got to get them. How do you think you cleaned up?
Bro, I don't know how you can be a guidance counselor and not fucking laugh. Well, I guess because it's sad, cause it's real.
Man.
But the thoughts are like going back and telling people, like your husband or your wife when you get home, I bet they laugh their ass off. Some shit like that. Like, man, I had to... Remember, I'll be telling you about Wanda.
This bitch got a thick-ass mustache. Damn, now I got to tell them to shave. I'm cool with Wanda having a thick-ass mustache. They say she got a shave.
They going to come get me out of my office.
So now Wanda looking at me like a bad guy. Now I got to tell Wanda to shave her thick-ass mustache.
Talking about I got to check her every morning when she coming to school. Put a light on her.
Say that's bullshit. Nah, she, goddamn it, she ain't got a head and mustache that thing.
Come here, Wanda.
Just trim it down, Wanda. That's all.
Even bought her some clippers.
Yeah.
Clippers.
She the only kid in the school that got a Christmas gift.
Why she get a gift? She needs that.
We gave her some for her birthday, but she didn't get the hint.
So we tried. Motherfucking, what's this shit called? The crane?
Oh, nair. Every morning when she walks in here, hit her with some nair. By the time she gets the first period, just wipe it on off.
Tell her it's Carmex or something.
I'll just put it in. I was going to say, tell her it's Carmex. Is it going to burn on it? So... I'm not sure how it works.
School getting sued.
Yeah, that's it.
Oh, shit.
Take the... Imagine just doing a swipe in there. Oh, as she walk in.
Mr. Doucet. My eyes are burning.
Oh, like, see, got a little on your eyebrows there, Wanda. It's okay.
Ooh.
Just go to class.
Got the Soulja Boy eyebrows.
Yeah. Got to sleep.
I didn't know people get that from scars also.
Yeah.
I followed her on Instagram. That was in her story today. She did not people be making me, like, ask me anything. Mm-hmm. She got a line in her shit. Somebody was like, did you shave that? Like, why do you, I always wanted to ask you why you had that. And she posted a picture with it of her as a babe, like a little kid. She had fucking stitches right here.
Damn.
And she was like, ever since this, it's always been there. I was like, damn. Ahead of your time.
I got a scar like that.
On your eyebrows?
Uh-uh. I got a scar like that. I had one on my foot like that.
How was that like that?
Hmm?
How was that like that?
Bro, I don't know, bro. I ripped it open on a chair or something.
No, how was that like the eyebrow scar?
Oh. I don't know. It's my jaw, but it's actually starting to get less noticeable the older I get. But for years, you could still see like the outline of where they did my stitches and stuff. I bust my jaw open.
Damn, and you bust your foot open too, apparently?
Separate incidents, but yeah.
I would hope so. I don't think you'd be with your parents if you bust your foot and your jaw at the same time. That'd be hard to explain.
Yeah. Couldn't explain it. Nobody was watching me, so.
Oh, yeah, it's over with.
Well, the first time, like, my mom was home, but she wasn't watching us.
I'm talking about if you did this at the same time.
Oh, yeah. Say, man. So
you coming out, can't talk and limping?
He's a ward of the state.
We'll just be holding him.
Don't even worry about it. That would have been bad.
It is funny. Well, it's not funny, actually. It's sad. It's a sad movie. But it actually worked out that the state took Kimberly Elise's kid and set it off. Because she ended up dying, like, the next week.
Well.
Or, like, the next day. It was very fast.
Well, yeah. So she would have died anyway. It's Luther's fault, honestly.
No, was it found the money? That's their fault. Why did you leave it in the vent?
That is what I said. But it's like they had nowhere else better to hide it. But they could have tucked
fucking
it.
Fucking Cleo had a whole fucking garage, bat cave, hideout thing. I guess. But I think the cops catch all that shit gone anyway, so.
Man. I said all they had to do was stick it a little further back there.
That too? Yeah, that bitch was right. You can see it through the grid.
And then if they had chairs in the way, what he looking? What is he looking in the? Like, how in the hell?
I figured he cut the air conditioner on and heard it. Because it was right there, so he probably, like a dollar blew out that hole. He was like, oh.
Damn. That motherfucking hurt.
Ooh. That's my money.
Yeah. That ain't too damn.
Smoked him.
Tell me, man. The most shy one hit.
Yeah, she had that. She worked that tool, bro. Dropped it. Yeah. Dropped it, about to shoot everybody else. Big gun, too.
So it's the top. Deshaun shot him.
I heard you. Took that bitch ID. That's one of the coldest things I've ever seen in a movie, too. Mm-hmm. Because you, it ain't nothing.
You can read an address back to you.
Say, and your name.
Say, yeah, but.
I ain't seen nothing. Didn't touch that bitch in the lineup. You think the cops would have saw that though?
Right. That's like, what I the see. Fuck? See, I'm not paying attention now.
You know this bitch. What's in your pocket? The only one. Hands on your side.
Say, hey, what are you doing?
Somebody go get him. Somebody go check her pocket.
This bitch is slow. Damn. Good ass movie, though.
Long as hell.
You know they did a stage play remake?
Mm hmm. I wouldn't have watched it, but.
Tyler Perry.
Oh, really?
Yeah. I think Lil Mama in that, too.
Oh,
I think.
Nothing against her.
Don't quote me. She make it less, you make me want to watch it a little less. Yeah. I got Tyler Perry, though. You was happy. You was excited.
I was. Tyler Perry. I like Tyler Perry. I never heard Lil Mama acting or nothing like that, so it doesn't get me excited. It was probably great.
Didn't even know she did that.
Yeah, it was probably great, though, so, I mean, hey, good for her. More life, more opportunities.
Hey, that's what it's about. Going up.
We're not even talking about the year no more. Some of my bitches with mustaches and shit.
That's what that's what the year brought us to.
I ain't see no bitches with mustaches. I might have.
I think
I ought to remember that.
I think I seen a couple older ladies with mustaches. So, what do you think is something that you really want to do in 2023 that you didn't get to do in 2022?
Something that I did not get to do.
Mm-hmm.
Anything? Just in life?
Like, if it's something in 2022, you say, oh, I want to do this. And it's like, oh, I ain't get to do it this year, but... I'm gonna do it this year. I'm gonna do it next year.
I guess I kind of said that already with the dude. I want to branch out more. But I mean, I didn't get to do it technically. So yeah, do more out of state stuff.
So. Okay.
Yeah, I guess. Because other stuff ain't really shit I want to do, but it's shit I didn't get to do. Mm. Like, I was almost in a play like 2 weeks ago.
Really?
I was almost in a play. So I could have said that, but I don't really give a fuck if I'm in a play or not.
Some lines? I would like to be in a play.
I would like to try it.
Yeah. Wow. It's fun.
You been in the play before?
I was a kid.
Okay. You sung? That was like one of the first things I asked when I was like, I got to sing.
It's a musical.
Well, so that's when I hear play, I think Tyler Perry. They singing all them bitches, so.
Not all plays that. You know, I sing. But no, I did not sing.
No. What was the play? Do you remember?
Amazing Grace.
That's a song.
No, that's the name of the play. God damn it.
Would they play Amazing Grace in the play?
No, the name of the main character, her name was Grace.
Was she amazing?
Yeah. There you go.
She's pretty amazing.
We have a line. There's a line in the play where we all say, "Amazing Grace." And we like, oh, right now. Like,
everybody clap.
No, I guess.
That's the name of the play. I told you she was amazing.
I remember I said that as like my ad lib line.
Oh, you off the dome. You had cold. You freestyled in the play.
They told me.
Boom, you just go crazy.
They told us we all could do it, but that was like my line that I used.
She's so amazing.
I told you she was
amazing. I told you she was amazing. Yeah. Did people cry?
Nah, I don't think nobody heard me like that because we was all saying stuff.
Oh, yeah, just
it was like a group of us.
Yelling shit.
It was coordinated but within the actors.
Mm. I mean, that sounds cool. Amazing Grace.
Mm-hmm. I was supposed to...
Did she juggle? Some shit like that?
Nah, but I don't know what she did. I don't really... I was a kid, so I didn't really read the full script. I just made sure I knew my lines, what I was supposed to say, which wasn't that much, honestly. But I had some stage time, so it was cool. I was supposed to be Travis and a Raven in the Sun.
Either you were supposed to be Travis?
Yeah. He's like the...
Travis Scott?
Mm-hmm.
Travis Barker?
That's the exact number. The exact one. Supposed to be, going crazy, jumping off stage.
That's what's up.
But he's like the son of the main character, I guess you could say.
This is something that was supposed to happen, or this is something that's going to happen?
No, that was something that was supposed to happen when I was younger.
Oh, okay. I got confused for a second.
The show got canceled, I think. Like, we got to all the way down to, like, getting ready to do the show, and it, like, got canceled or something. So.
Okay.
Didn't get to do that, but it would have been fun.
Gotcha.
Still got the whole experience of getting ready for it, though. We would meet at the library, like, twice a week.
Practice? Rehearsal? Mm-hmm. Yeah, I ain't never done no shit like that, so I'd like to try it and see.
It's a cool little process, and definitely something to be proud of once you're done. It's like, damn, I really memorizing lines. Because, bro, that shit.
I already know. I do that already.
It's like a mind muscle memory you got to, like.
That's what it is.
It's got to trigger, because, like, if you learn the lines, you can't just learn your lines. You got to learn the lines that's right before.
Yeah.
So you got to, you know what I'm saying? You got to be on point. You ever saw that clip where they say Will Smith, when they first started Fresh Prince, they used to have to, like, get on him. But they had to tell him to cover his mouth because he would be saying.
He's saying everybody's lines.
Yeah,
that's how he learned it. Yeah, I saw that. They say you can see it in some of the first episodes. Mm-hmm. Yeah, I know about that. Oh, I got something though. Do my own show. Book a show. Mm-hmm. That's something I want to do.
Like, get all the comics and stuff?
Yeah. I've been told a bunch of times I need to do that. And I just never done it. So I need to try it.
The Joseph Folk umbrella?
Maybe. Like probably. I definitely have it on the poster or something. Yeah. It'd be a part of it.
We can I was just thinking about that.
Sure. I definitely want to do that. I want to see what it's like. Everybody say it's cool, so... I want to try that this year and do branch out shit.
So, all right, cool. We talk about that. We can get that. We can figure that out.
Is there something you want to do in 2023?
It's a lot of stuff. I want to
pick one.
Quit my job.
Right, I'm with that. That's every year.
That was the one. You said pick one, so I picked that.
All right, pick another one. Okay, not just quit, like, just, I want to quit because fuck that shit. I mean, it is that, but quit with something else popping.
Right, right.
Yeah, don't just quit your job because it's January 1st.
Yeah, definitely not.
But yeah, my bad. And start an LLC, you said?
Yeah, this will lead to me quitting my job, hopefully. And get my real estate license.
There you go. They take less than a year?
They have a 1 month class, three months, six months.
Yes, that's all you had to say. Yes. 1 month and 3 months, yes, most definitely.
Quick, fast, and in a hurry.
Okay, so we hit the hour.
We did. I guess we can wrap it up. How you? You asked a good question. That should have been the wrap. I guess that can be the wrap up question.
wrap it up.
Any shout out?
Shout out to
everybody. My bad.
Shout out to the Joseph Float All Stars.
Everybody that's been on it in 2022.
Yeah,
I can't even think of everybody that's been on this. But pretty much everybody's season 3. That's everybody. Man. That's everybody this year. Man. Yeah. Everybody in season 3. Fucking Alana, Loco, Will Merrill. First guest of the year was Will Merrill. Shout out to Will. Mm-hmm. Mike Honoray. Pastor Petty.
Yeah.
Mark Caesar. Mm-hmm. We had My Name Dwayne. Mm-hmm. Jamil was this season? Last season?
Yeah.
Shout out to her anyway, then.
Mm-hmm. Jeremiah,
the last episode. Mm-hmm. JD Ely was on here.
And,
that's most of them. I think.
The other dude, not JD, the other, the comic that's always at all the black shows. White comic, that's all the facts. Did he do the show? Can't remember his name. Wear the shirts.
Wes?
Yes.
No, he wasn't on it.
Oh.
He was supposed to be, but he wasn't. Yeah. Damn. Oh, shout out Jess Kenny. Another guest.
Mm-hmm.
I think that's it. That's most of them, like I said. If I did not say your name, I apologize. Shout out to you too. We appreciate everybody that's been on the Joseph Flo podcast.
Forever.
Just like we appreciate everybody else that's going to be on the Joseph Flo podcast.
Hit us up, man. Come sit and talk.
But anyway, man, shout out. Who else can I shout out? Shout out Blair. Shout out my people. Shout out
Indigo Sun.
Shout out Indigo Sun.
Shout out J True.
Shout out
Sid.
Shout out Juwan Ford.
Yeah.
Probably the first time I ever said it.
Yeah, shout out Juwan Ford. Shout out to Mighty Nyree. Shout out to you for watching.
Yes, man. And we hope you enjoyed this. Mm-hmm. We hope you enjoy whatever episodes you watched in 2022. If you missed any, go back and watch them.
Right. Let us know what your favorite episode was and what you want to see next season, because we're coming back with a
more
flavor in your ear, man.
You said more flavor or new flavor?
New flavor. More flavor, new flavor. Yes, all the same.
Well, all the same, all hand in hand. But anyways,
one hand washes the other, and both of them wash the face.
Yeah, they wash everything else too.
Hey, holla back, man. Happy New Year,
back player. Well, yeah, man, we appreciate whoever watches in 2023. More to come, all like, that good shit.
Comment, subscribe, share. You know the routine, man. Tell your mama, tell her mama, tell her to tell her brother, sister, uncle, mother, cousin. You know what I'm saying, man.
Yeah. And tell them to buy some motherfucking merch.
Hey, merch it.
Yeah.
Merch
it. On the next one.
Twist your fingers. You can stick it up.